This is Volzmir, and you're watching my Deus Ex Human Revolution No Kill Stealth Walkthrough, Episode 12. This is a non-commentary walkthrough. Click on the annotations or refer to the timestamps in the description to navigate through the video.
Jensen! Jensen, can you read me?
Barely. I've reached Panchaea, Pritchard. Any word from Sarah for the UN delegates?
Nothing. The installation went into lockdown shortly after Darrow gave his speech. I can't tell if anyone's even alive. And the signal's still broadcasting.
Meaning no one's safe till I get in there and shut it down.
You'll have to disengage the lockdown first. Look for a master control panel at the top of the tower.
Pritchard, Panchea's broadcast center is at the base of the station near the bottom of the ocean. Is that right?
But the lockdown caused all the blast doors to seal. You won't be able to go down until you override them manually.
From up in the tower. I got it.
I don't think you want to do that, Mr. Jensen. Disengage lockdown, and whatever demons this station contains are likely to come crashing out on us.
Afraid to die, Darrow? Or just unwilling to face what you've done?
Oh, I know what I've done, believe me. I take no pleasure in it.
And yet you still did it.
I did what had to be done. 20 years ago, I gave the world augmentation technology. I thought I was giving it a bright future, but instead I gave it the means to destroy itself. No law, no UN regulation was going to fix that.
People are dying out there. Hundreds of thousands of people driven to the brink of insanity because of you.
I had to convince the world. Before today, people believed we should steal fire from the gods and redesign human nature. Human nature is the only thing we have that gives us a moral compass and the social skills we need to live in peace. Destroy it, and you destroy our very species.
Don't paint yourself a savior in this. What you're doing is insane.
Is it? When this is done, the Illuminati won't be able to control men and women like you as they had planned, from the inside out. No one will be able to use the technology I invented to make others into beings they desire. Something we both know has happened already.
think you're Frankenstein, killing his own monster.
Actually, Mr. Jensen, I prefer to think of myself as Daedalus, watching helplessly as his child crashes into the sea.
I'm ending this now.
You can't. The signal is being generated from the broadcast center at the base of this facility. Panchea's security system has been programmed to protect it, and will kill you before you even get close.
You designed that system, Darrow. You can tell me how to shut it down.
But I won't. You think what I'm doing is extreme. You simply don't understand. For humanity to survive beyond this century, it must abandon ill-conceived notions about transcendence and embrace change. But for that to happen, the hard lesson must be learned. Blood must be shed.
What you're doing is horrific. It has to stop. You can't force people to change. They have to do it on their own, or they'll end up resenting you for it. And doing it like this? My God, Darrow, it's insane.
It is not insane, Mr. Jensen. Tragic, yes. Unavoidable? No. Even as I listen to your words, I realize a cruel truth. No one else has the vision to see what I've seen, the will to do what I have done. You're all too weak, judging but never acting. None of you have the moral courage to see this through to its conclusion. Well, so be it.
Maybe you're right. Maybe you're wrong. None of it matters, because this is what will happen now. After today, whatever you say will be dismissed as the ravings of a mass murderer. You were one of the greatest minds of our time, and tomorrow you'll be nothing but a killer.
But they can't think that. They'll be missing the point. Oh, why did I expect this to turn out differently? People like you, people who willingly surrender their humanity a piece at a time, you'll never understand. And browbeating won't get me to change my mind. You can talk and talk and talk, but in the end, you'll still fail to grasp the fundamental underlying truth.
People like me? People like me? You're not interested in saving humanity, Darrow, no matter how loud you shout it. This is about jealousy, pure and simple. Everything you're doing today is in service to your wounded ego, because you can't stand anyone leaving you behind.
My ego has nothing to do with this. And if your mind, your psyche, wasn't so addled by the technology I invented, you might be able to see that. Once upon a time, I would have given all I had to be like you. But genetics cheated me of that chance, cursed me to become a cripple. And you know what? I'm relieved. Because I look in your eyes and I see how disturbed you are by what you have become. Admit it, Mr. Jensen. You've done things with those enhancements of yours you would never have considered before. You know your humanity is ebbing away.
You cover it up with all that pretense about saving the world, try to justify it. But deep down inside, you're nothing more than an angry child. Spiteful, full of hate, envious and bitter. How petty is that?
Petty? I was betrayed by my own genetics, ruined by my own flesh. What right do you have to condemn me, to curse me? All I ever wanted was to build something good. Something magnificent. And now, there's so much blood. So much blood. I will give you what you want, Mr. Jensen. codes to shut down Panchea's security system. But you'll still be in danger. Much of the system is self-determining and lethal. When you see it, maybe then you'll understand. The technology I created will not be the future any one of us desires. Please, help the world understand that.
Richard, the lockdown's disengaged. I'm heading back to the hangar to see if those blast doors are open. Have you been able to raise anyone?
I'm picking up several glimmers, but there's too much interference. I think you're on your own, Jensen.
Careful there, Francis. You almost sound like you regret that.
You're the one! That was Nike. Please, let it be nothing.
What? Ow! Identify yourself!
Relatively normal. Nishbar?
All things considered, yeah. You okay?
Thankfully, I was able to barricade myself in here when things got out of control. So, is it safe to come out now?
No. The rest of the station is still under siege. You better stay here until help comes. In the meantime, is it possible to download Praxis software here?
Yes, of course. No damage was done to the computers. See for yourself. Remain here, where it's safe. If you need help, or get word of help, please come back.
This is William Taggart. If anyone out there is listening, I'm begging you, help. We've barricaded ourselves inside the core server room. Many of us are wounded. Please, save us. Please, save us.
Thank you. Access granted.
Mr. Jensen, how ironic that you should be the one to save us from the monsters out there.
Monsters, Taggart? You mean people. Augmented people who've lost all control, lost their reason.
Isn't that supposed to be my line? Unfortunately, it seems your esteemed Mr. Darrow decided to appropriate my point and turn it back on me. In madness and in blood. He has betrayed us all.
So you finally admit it. You are part of this, after all. You have been all along.
It would be pointless to deny anything now, but despite what you think of us, we never wanted augmentations outlawed. All we've ever sought is regulation, rules governing how the technology is developed, and laws that ensure it's used for the good of society.
You've raised society above humanity. So who gets to make those rules?
Men with wisdom, strength, and tenacity to know what's right. Proven leaders who distinguish themselves, like you, Mr. Jensen. You've certainly earned the right to be one of us. All you have to do is take it.
I'm not looking for glory, Taggart.
Just remember that without control, there's no room for freedom, only anarchy. You were a policeman once. You know the importance of order.
I know there's a difference between order and slavery.
The biochip wasn't supposed to force people to do anything. It merely limited power so that people couldn't go on killing sprees like the ones taking place right now.
Amazing how well that worked out.
Say what you will, but I know that some part of you agrees with me. Absolute freedom is no different than absolute chaos. Society needs boundaries if it has any hope of surviving. And you, Mr. Jensen, can be the one to give us that hope. Shut down Darrow's signal. Then help me get a message out saying that an accident at VersaLife contaminated the world's neuropazine supply.
VersaLife? And what if I decided to blame the Illuminati?
The Illuminati is just a name to get rich financiers to invest more money. Besides, do you really think the world will believe in some 18th century conspiracy theory? Do this for us, and you'll ensure a future for mankind, all of mankind, augmented or otherwise. The future Hugh Darrow offers doesn't allow for both.
Let me think about it.
Oh, thank God you came. I've got wounded here. We'll have to move them first.
We can't move anyone yet. Not until I get to the base of the station and shut down Darrow's broadcast.
What? Why?
The chaos you experienced here, it's everywhere. The Illuminati created a biochip that stops people from using enhanced abilities, and Darrow turned it into a kill switch.
Oh my God, you. We gotta fix this, Adam. If people realize what's happened, if they believe augmentation technology created this chaos, they'll ban human enhancement research forever.
And that would be a bad thing.
Yes, it would! Don't you see what's at stake here? Ever since man first crawled out of that ocean, we've been striving to be more than we are. Augmentation technology is just the latest, greatest step on a very long road. But we've barely scratched the surface of its potential. We can't let fear stop us from continuing.
That's your belief, Sarif. Not everyone shares it.
But you do, Adam. I know it. And if we work together, we can really make a difference. We can improve the lives of everyone, but only if we fix this.
Go on.
We'd have to get a message out after you shut down Hugh's signal. Tell the world, tell them the Humanity Front did this, that their doctors created a virus that only affects augmented people.
You mean lie.
It'll give us time, son. Time to figure out how to destroy the Illuminati's biochips and move on.
And what about the people who've been hurt by this? Don't they deserve the truth?
I had them. If we want the freedom to become more than we are, we can't be blinded by a misguided morality. Some people will be left behind. It's reality. It's evolution, son.
Right. Evolution based on my DNA.
Please, son, you have to stay with me on this.
I'll think about it.
Die! Get off! Die! Get that! One more! Stop it! No, no, there's no one here. It's all in your head.
What the hell? Oh my God.
Water pressure nominal at 173 psi.
Who am I?
Communications web online.
I feel cold.
Drones 1 through 3 within operational parameters.
I don't remember.
Drone 4, disconnected.
Let me go.
Processing.
Oh God, please help me. I'm scared.
Core temperature stable. Processing.
Zhao, what are you doing?
Connecting to Panchea's Haran project, Mr. Jensen. The most advanced quantum computer slave to the human brain, and the closest to perfection we'll ever achieve. I'm going to use it to hack Darrow's signal and rework the message to our benefit.
Our benefit? You mean the Illuminati's?
Someone has to override the signal and be the world's savior. And let's be honest, neither of us would trust anyone else to fill that role. Computer, begin EEG sync.
So much pain.
Sinking beta waves at 40 cycles per second.
Sal, get them out of there. I have to reach the control chamber.
No! I can feel control! I'm in control!
Stop the signal!
Security, alert.
Through the primary control
panel. Oh, shit.
Security in place. To access Alpha Pod, purge tertiary pods.
one to alter the signal. Once I do, the Council will welcome me with open arms.
No! Protect Mother!
Error in system.
Aron is weakening.
Rerouting connection.
I am regaining control. I must...
Reroute complete.
I'll do it, Mother. Just don't hurt anymore. Just no more pain. Please, keep him away from us. Security measures are sufficient. Insufficient.
Error in system. Rerouting connection. Reroute complete. Thank you.
Adam. Welcome to the Edge. It is not the end of the world, but you can see it from here.
Eliza? What are you doing here?
It is my job to monitor and report on the news, Adam. Before Darrow smothered everything with his signal, the whole world was tuned into this place, including me.
The broadcast. I have to stop it.
I know. Please, come closer. Do you know where we are, Adam? We are at the fulcrum point, when society lies in the balance. Hugh Darrow hoped to tip the scales one way, by telling the world everything you already know. About the biochip, the Illuminati, everything. He believed knowing the truth would convince mankind to abandon research into human enhancement technologies forever.
It would certainly give them reason to fear it.
Indeed. Darrow's confession is ready to send. If you want, I can wideband it across all media as soon as you shut down the signal. Everything you worked so hard to uncover will be exposed. But only if you deactivate the broadcast using this control. However, if you desire, I can alter Darrow's message. Conceal the creation of the biochip while putting in new content.
Content blaming the Humanity Front, like Sarif suggested.
The organization has already admitted to harboring terrorists. It would be easy to convince people they turn to biological warfare in a more desperate attempt to get rid of augmented people.
But why? What would that achieve?
In time, it could shift the focus of hatred onto people whose prejudices are seen as too extreme, leaving corporations free to experiment with human evolution as they desire. But if you want me to perform this edit for you, you must disengage the signal and activate the video edit function from here. Alternatively, Darrow's message can be adjusted to erase all mention of the power group known as the Illuminati. I can report that lack of proper regulation allowed vast quantities of neuropazine to become contaminated prior to reaching the market.
Taggart's preference. You think the world will buy a made-up story about neuropazine poisoning?
You might be surprised by what people believe. I can convince them. And having experienced the negative effects of corporate negligence firsthand, a majority of people might force the world to place harsh restrictions on all human enhancement research. But only if you disengage the signal and activate the video edit function from here. Of course, there is another option. This passage leads to Panchaea's pressure regulation controls. Destroy them and the installation will cave in on itself, overwhelmed by the weight of the ocean pressing against it. Everyone inside the structure will die.
That's a solution?
No one will be left to tell the world what happened, Adam. Nobody will be able to spin the story.
Including me.
The choice is yours. Do you believe you have the wisdom to choose an appropriate future for mankind? Or do you trust mankind to find the answers on its own? If you do this, the unadulterated truth in Darrow's confession may well convince mankind to cast all science and technology aside, to ensure that future generations grow up free and whole. Are you sure this is your choice? So be it then.
Albert Einstein said, "Technological progress is like an axe in the hands of a pathological criminal." It took me a while, but I finally see his point. How often have we chased the dream of progress only to see it perverted? More often than not, haven't the machines we built to improve life shattered the lives of millions? And now we want to turn that dream on ourselves to fundamentally improve who we are. Experience has shown me how dangerous that can be. How many times, in the Call of Duty, did I almost fall into the trap of taking shortcuts, abusing my abilities or the resources at hand? I resisted. Barely at times, because I valued human lives and considerations. Can I truly despise others who fall? Technology offers us strength. Strength enables dominance, and dominance paves the way for abuse. Darrow understood this. He knew that using technology to become something more than we are risks losing our ability to love, aspire, or make moral choices. The very things that make us human. It also risks giving some men the power to make others what they choose, regardless of the cost to human dignity. The suffering Darrow inflicted is not the end of the world. It is merely the seed for change. And change never comes without pain.
If you do this, the focus of hatred may shift to those responsible for unleashing biological warfare, leaving corporations free to experiment with human evolution. Are you sure this is your choice? So be it then.
Sarif was right about one thing. It's in our nature to want to rise above our limits. Think about it. We were cold, so we harnessed fire. We were weak, so we invented tools. Every time we met an obstacle, we used creativity and ingenuity to overcome it. The cycle is inevitable. But will the outcome always be good? I guess that will depend on how we approach it. These past few months, I was challenged many times. But more often than not, didn't I try to keep morality in mind, knowing that my actions didn't have to harm others? Time and time again, didn't I resist the urge to abuse power and resources simply to achieve my goals more swiftly? In the past, we've had to compensate for weaknesses, finding quick solutions that only benefit a few. But what if we never need to feel weak or morally conflicted again? What if the path Sarif wants us to take enables us to hold on to higher values with more stability? One thing is obvious. For the first time in history, we have a chance to steal fire from the gods. To turn away from it now, to stop pursuing a future in which technology and biology combine, leading to the promise of a singularity, would mean to deny the very essence of who we are. No doubt the road to get there will be bumpy, hurting some people along the way. But won't achieving the dream be worth it? We can become the gods we've always been striving to be. We might as well get good at it.
If you do this, first-hand experience with corporate negligence on such a grand scale may convince mankind to enact harsh restrictions on human enhancement research. Are you sure this is your choice? So be it then.
Freedom. To those who don't have it, it's more valuable than gold. But where should it start and end? We humans often think we have the right to expand, absorb, convert, or possess anything we need to reach our dreams. But time and time again, hasn't this led to conflicts with others who essentially believe the same thing? Looking back on the challenges I faced, at the way I often resolve them, I realize morality can become our saving grace. Most of the time, didn't I try to keep my values in mind, knowing how my actions would affect others? More often than not, I resisted the urge to abuse power and resources simply to reach my goals more swiftly. I managed to hang on to my humanity. But the temptation to ignore it was always there. It's that temptation that so worries Taggart. He's not afraid of freedom. He's afraid of the chaos that erupts when individuals have nothing but morality to constrain them. He wants us to regulate enhancement technologies because he fears all that power without limits, without guardrails to keep us from abusing it. Absolute freedom is no better than chaos. Society needs laws and regulations to protect it. So if the men and women behind Taggart need to work in the shadows, pulling strings to enable us to head in a safe direction, will supporting them be all that bad? If they're as wise as Taggart says, how bad will their leadership be? I just hope they stand by what they say.
If you do this, the world will be left with questions and may never reach a consensus. Are you sure this is your choice? We have little time left, Adam. And might I say, it has been a pleasure.
Do I trust mankind to save itself? That's what Eliza was asking. The truth is, I don't know. After everything I've seen, all the fighting and the chaos around me, I only know what I want to believe. Somehow, human decency will triumph. These past few months, I've faced many life-threatening situations. I could have given up many times, but my need to know the truth, to uncover the secrets that others were hiding, and to survive, forced me to keep on going. Most of the time, I tried to keep my values in mind, knowing my actions did not have to harm others. I held on to my humanity, resisting the urge to abuse power or resources in order to meet my goals. And in the end, I got the job done. But does this mean I have the right to choose for everyone? No. Because it isn't up to me. It isn't up to Darrow, Sarif, or Taggart either. Ordinary men and women will have to decide together what course mankind should take. The kind of people who time and time again have picked and chosen the future in highly practical ways, slowing change when it's negative, speeding it up when it's good. Can they do it again? I don't know. But I do know I'm not about to let anyone in this station, myself included, stand in their way.
I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you want to watch more, please subscribe to my channel, Volzmir Gaming. You can follow me on Twitter on @Volzmir to keep up to date with my latest content. Feel free to leave your thoughts down below in the comments section, and as always, thanks for watching.